Hi, welcome to Analog Communication course. In this video, we will discuss the concept of finding Fourier transforms for periodic signals. Consider a signal GP of t, which is periodic. We can write this using exponential Fourier series as sigma cn e power j n omega naught t. So where omega naught is equal to 2 pi by t naught. So the objective is to find out the Fourier transform of this periodic signal. So I apply the same here, Fourier transform of sigma cn e power j n omega naught, I write 2 pi by t naught into t. So this we can write as sigma cn Fourier transform of e power j n omega naught t. Say we have one property of Fourier transform. Say if g of t and g of f form the Fourier transform pair, then Fourier transform of g of t into e power j omega naught t is g of f minus f naught. Okay, here in place of omega naught, we have n omega naught. Okay, so we can write, but what is g of t here? Here, g of t is 1. If g of t is 1, g of f is delta of f. Okay, it is something like we are trying to find out the Fourier transform of 1 into j n omega naught t. So it becomes delta of f minus nf naught, delta of f minus nf naught. So I replace the same here. This becomes sigma cn delta of f minus nf naught. So here the conclusion is, for a periodic signal, the Fourier transform consists of all impulses. Okay, say for example at frequency zero, f naught, 2f naught, 3f naught. Okay, here its magnitude, just I take different color, the magnitude is c0, C1, C2, C3. Okay, the same thing for negative frequencies. So the Fourier transform of periodic signal is discrete in nature. So for example, we try to find out the Fourier transform of one periodic signal, that is impulse train. Okay, so this is one impulse, this is another impulse, 2t naught, same thing applies to negative frequencies, so on. This is time axis. Okay, so this impulse train I can write as, say, gp of t is equal to sigma delta of t minus nt naught for where t naught is the time period. Now we have to find out the Fourier transform of this signal, periodic signal. So as explained, so the Fourier transform of periodic signal, any periodic signal, is Cn into delta of f minus nf naught. So the problem simply boils down to finding out Cn value of that particular periodic signal. Okay. So the coefficient Cn from the exponential Fourier series, so it is simply Cn is equal to 1 by t naught over 1 period, okay, say minus t naught by 2 to plus t naught by 2 gp of t, okay, e power minus j n omega naught t dt. So from minus t naught by 2 to plus t naught by 2 gp of t is simply delta of t, okay, so that is 1 by t naught, it is delta of t into e power minus j n omega naught t dt. So from the properties of impulse functions, if you multiply any function with impulse function, so it is something like this. So if I multiply a signal g of t with delta of t, the result is g of 0 into delta of t. It is simply multiplication of two signals. So it comes as 1 by t naught into delta of t into this signal value at t equal to 0. So it becomes e power minus j 0, 1. Okay. So it is 1 by t naught integral delta of t dt. So integral delta of dt is 1. So c naught or cn value is 1 by t naught. Okay, for all n. So I can rewrite this as 1 by t naught sigma n delta of f minus n f naught. So if I plot this function, so this is also an impulse train, okay, but the amplitude here becomes 1 by t naught for all the impulses. This is frequency 0, f naught, 2 f naught, minus f naught, so on, where f naught is 1 by t naught. So the summary is the Fourier transform of any periodic signal is discrete in nature, and the amplitudes of each impulses are dependent on the Cn value. And we try to find out the Fourier transform of impulse train. So the Fourier transform of impulse train is also impulse train, okay, and its amplitude is 1 by t. Thank you.